you put that up near your head, will that help? And then it's skateboard coming over. Is that going to be all right?
It's hot in here.
Why am I in the boot of a car underneath a pile of skateboards and dirty clothes filming in the fetal position? My last clip for Violent Soho. Single shot, no edits, and now they want another one. Some of my favourite long takes in cinema are from the film Children of Men. Since then, I've wanted to replicate the road ambush scene for a music video, but haven't found the right budget or song. Turns out Soho's next single is perfect, but compared to Alfonso Cuarón's budget, the band has about this much to spend. No choice but to get all MacGyver on its ass. Find a car on Gumtree, tow it home and push it off by hand because someone left the keys on the grass at the owner's place 80 kilometres away. I've already got a motion control rig I've used on clips for Z-Flex and Ballpark Music, amongst others. It's got a joystick to pan and tilt the camera, plus twist controls to move up and down the track. Just need to find a way to mount the whole thing to the roof. I've got a mate who can build anything, and he's a surgeon with an angle grinder. So we give the car a custom sunroof, weld up some heavy-duty roof racks, and mount the rig upside down. A curtain rod keeps the control cables from getting munted, and a gaffed-up tarp keeps the sun and rain out. Replace the dash mat with something cooler, and fill the car with stuff that means something to the band. Rig the camera on a quick-release plate with motorized focus controls that work in the boot as well as on the run, because the breakdown in the song is the perfect moment to mess with everyone's heads by going from smooth motion control to jerky handheld with no cuts. Get the band to put out an extras call on social media and find four featured non-professional actors for the car. Find an industrial estate with a loading dock for a guerrilla gig stage and hope that people show up. Thank God for fans. Fans that are willing to hang out in the heat for hours. Fans that willingly volunteer to sprint like maniacs along deserted streets over and over again. And a band cool enough to play sets between takes to show their appreciation to a loyal crowd. 4 hours later, we had it in the can. Of course, the best take wasn't the one with the nicest lighting or the best composition. Just the moment when all the variables came together best. A bit of raw file manipulation, grade tweaking, and a layer of simulated film grain, and it's good to go. With the added bonus of nailing the nostalgic Smashing Pumpkins vibe the band were after. None of this happens without tons of help. A producer who pulls blood from a budgetary stone, his assistant who also sprints on every take, a guy who actually speaks robot, makeup, BTS camera, and a featured cast who are impervious to weed and beer and nail it on every take. That's how you push through when shit happens. When the car chassis jams on the trailer as darkness falls. When the back window spontaneously shatters overnight because you've messed with the car's structural integrity. When the boot locks itself 3 takes in a row at the most crucial moment. And then when you finally get out of the boot, eating it bad. And when you find yourself the day after sweeping up cigarette butts, knowing you've done it all for free, at least you know it's for a good cause, for good people.